Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 2 Blind. I'm the RPG chick, as always. Just finished fighting the collectors. Got dragged out here to the Caleston Rift. And we have never been here. Let's look at that. This planet is bigger than the sun it's orbiting. Is that possible? So we gotta check out the Balor system and then other systems, and we got another firewalker thing to go around here, and other than that, we'll probably run into some quests, but as of now, that's the only one. Now we have more fuel, which is great. We actually have more probes as a result. Wasn't aware of that. That works out. This is a little... Okay, I'm seeing a rock. Can't do that. Alright, so this big planet... Cernunnos. Oh, I know that name from somewhere. Cernunnos is a sizable gas giant with a hydrogen-nitrogen atmosphere. It is believed to be an extrasolar capture due to its close stellar location. In a rare phenomenon, it is near enough to its red dwarf star to be within the life zone, though its massive size prevents the tidal lock that usually occurs at such a range. While nothing could survive on the surface of a planet with such crushing gravity, Cernunnos' moon Caleston is habitable. Cernunnos is skimmed for its abundant hydrogen, and refineries on Caleston process it into a metastable metallic form for use as starship fuel. Now, we have exhausted a lot of our materials, so we definitely need some more. Especially iridium, we use so much. I mean, iridium was like around 100,000, I believe. So this is moderate. So we are definitely going to be getting some minerals of all kinds today.
Launching probe.
Yes, you were. You're right, it's only moderate.
Probe launched.
What?
Probe away.
Building up our platinum quickly. Didn't use that much of it. Can we get this any higher?
Launching probe.
Kind of a waste, but... Okay. This planet, which is right there. Caleston. Oh yeah, this is the moon. The hostile moon Caleston is the largest satellite of the gas giant Cernunnos. An ancient asteroid strike deposited major loads of element zero within the molten sulfur mantle. I like the sound of that. Eldfeld Ashland's energies mining operations have made it the largest source of starship drive core material in the Attican Traverse. Caleston is racked with volcanism due to tidal stresses from Cernunnos. Because of weak solar output, plant-like life on Caleston is not carbon-based and photosynthetic, but silicon-based and thermosynthetic, requiring heat rather than sunlight to power its chemical reactions. These organisms flourish in volcanic vents and during solar flares when Balor can double or triple in luminosity. Sadly, sapient habitation is not possible here, and Caleston's biodiversity is considered threatened by the Citadel Council Committee on Habitable Worlds. Oh wow. There's a population of 1,802,705,000. colony was founded in 1975. At the height of the disco era. Hey, it's not that far from Earth's standards here. Rich, yes, please, on element zero. Well, we got right here. Well, there's some. We can get a little of both right here. I want to get the element zero up, actually. You hear the element zero? It's like... Yeah, this is the highest we can get it right here.
Probe launched.
Nice. Oh, there's more.
Probe launched.
Yes. Fucking awesome. Look at that. Nice. Right there.
Launching probe.
That's the sweet spot right there.
Launched.
I don't think we got any higher than that.
Probe away. Probe away. Probe.
Yeah, not much to say here, just gathering minerals. Or materials. What do you want to call this crap?
Probe away.
I should have favored the element zero actually a bit more. Anyway, so we're done. Okay, so this one. Alatha. A tiny rock planet, Alatha is noted for its frigid temperatures and crushing nitrogen and krypton atmosphere. Lying out beyond the Fomor belt, there is little to recommend it. Except it's rich in materials.
Launching probe.
Some iridium. More iridium.
Probe launched.
I can barely see the lines here. The grid. So once they get 100 and stuff, I'll stop, you know, collecting it. Oh, nice.
Launched. Launching probe.
La-ti-da.
Probe launched.
Before you know it, I'll have all the platinum and palladium we'll need. At least for now. I saw something. Yeah. I think I missed something here.
Probe away.
Okay. Next planet. I have an itch. Need to scratch. Alright, so we got one more planet. The last orbit is the Mass 4 relay. Partholon. A large planet composed of ice surrounding a rocky core, Partholon retains trace gases of nitrogen and carbon monoxide. Its crushing gravity makes for an inhospitable stay and makes most mining infeasible. However, its orbit's proximity to the mass relay in the system means space travelers will, for the next few years, use it for gravitational slingshot to add speed on their way to and from Caleston. Poor guy getting used like that.
Launching probe.
Oops.
Probe away.
Palladium and iridium. And what was that? Platinum iridium. Here's a lot of palladium though.
Probe away. Launching probe.
Here we go.
Probe launched.
So we're done with this system.
Probe away.
Wait, there's a spike here. Yeah, I missed some of this stuff on the first pass.
Probe away.
The platinum. Alright. Okay, more fuel. Or probes, rather. Oh no, I'm not going to the mass relay. I'm going to... let's go to Azer. So let's go to Talava. Four planets. Innermost planet is Taitus. A large rock planet orbiting an F-class star, Taitus is pummeled by radiation, heavy gravity, and tectonic activity. Its crust is mostly silicates and of little value. Travel is not advised. Moderate.
Probe away.
Palladium.
Probe away.
Iridium. And what else?
Launching probe.
Platinum. Here we go. Way up here.
Launching probe.
At the tops, they escape me. Okay. Well, the poles, rather. Okay, second planet from the sun is... Cautious. Cautious. Be careful now. Be cautious. Home to the spectacular Infinity Caldera, Cautious is a young planet with... I don't know what that is. With extreme tectonic and volcanic activity, with 9 supervolcanoes that can throw out at least 1,000 cubic kilometers of dense rock equivalents each, Cautious's activity has put its atmosphere in a state of shroud. It will likely suffer from global dimming for at least the next 10 years, though much of the surface is no more dangerous than many other inner ring planets. This extreme tectonic activity has given Cautious a bad reputation and discouraged all resource exploitation. Scanner results are good. Yes, son. I'll take both. A little of both. Iridium and platinum. And a bit of palladium. That looks different, that one. I guess because there's more than one. I don't know.
Launching probe.
Yeah. I never noticed them looking like that. With the green flag and the red thing.
Probe away.
Maybe that's the result of the probe upgrade I got.
Probe away. Probe away.
Really close to the point where I will hold off on getting more platinum.
Launching probe. Probe launched.
Oops. Here we go. No platinum, baby.
Probe launched.
Third planet. Matrim. A small, hot rock with few resources, Matrim is used by the Turian Armed Forces for its maximum security prison and interrogation centers. The temperatures are high enough to prevent any escape without an environmental suit, but low enough that construction of additional buildings will not be hindered. Over 500,000 prisoners are detained on Matrim, only a handful of which have ever managed even a temporary escape. A small supply economy and prefab habitats support the prison staff, who usually work only for 2 year tours of duty before they were rotated out to less stressful positions.
Wow.
So it's another Turian prison, huh? Rich in resources.
Probe launched.
More platinum.
Probe away.
Palladium. Man, this game is so much darker than the first game.
Probe launched.
I can't even trust this freaking guy who's basically leading us. I mean, he's... We're not really following his orders, but he's tricking us into doing everything. It's ridiculous. And when we say we can't trust him, he says, oh, it's about a grudge. I'm like, no, it's just... We can't trust you. We're not stupid.
Probe launched.
Iridium and palladium.
Probe away.
More iridium, right? That's pretty high.
Probe away. Probe launched.
Plenty of stuff here.
Away.
Iridium and some palladium. Okay. Interesting. Nothing on any of these planets so far. No distress signals or anything like that.
Anomaly detected.
Spoke too soon. Taitus. A desert of whitish potassium salts and reddish iron oxides, Taitus is far enough away from its parent star to have a tolerable surface temperature. Though it has only a trace atmosphere of carbon dioxide and oxygen, it is still hospitable enough for criminals and determinist systems to use it as a staging base. Turian patrols sometimes fly through the area looking to preempt jailbreak attempts on Matrim's prisons. Travel advisory. Unregistered starships have been spotted in the vicinity of Taitus. Civilian travel is not recommended. Orbital period is 6 Earth years. The day length is just over 22 hours. Atmospheric pressure trace. Surface temperature, about freezing. Surface gravity just slightly below that of Earth in the scan. We got rich results. Let's see what the thing says first.
If you think you can get it to work, you're freaking welcome to it. Welcome to it. Repeat, there's a piece of crap mech on this planet's surface. If you think you can get it to work, you're freaking welcome to it. Welcome to it. Repeat, there's a piece of crap mech on this planet's surface. If you think you can get...
Piece of crap what? Piece of crap map?
Welcome to it. Repeat, there's a piece of crap mech on this planet's surface. If you think you can get it to work,
mech?
You're freaking welcome to it. Welcome to it.
Probe launched.
That's a lot of palladium.
Welcome to it. Repeat, there's a piece of crap mech on this planet's surface.
Probe away.
That's so funny, he leaves a message like that.
Probe away.
Welcome to it.
Probe launched. Launching probe.
Saying mech, I think.
Welcome to it. Repeat, there's a piece of crap mech on this planet's surface. If you think you can get it to work, you're freaking welcome to it. Welcome to it.
Launching probe. Scans have found something.
Yeah, mech. Surface scans detect one Emer heavy mech signature matching an unknown, possibly pirate registration. Mech appears to be disabled but broadcasting a looping message. Message does not appear to be a distress signal. Research scans indicate large quantities of mineral resources available, but obscured behind walls of dense stone. Huh. Guess we're landing. Who do you take? Who should we take? Take Saeed and Garrus, why not? Two points, I'm saving him. I guess for, well, either Assault Mastery or Shockwave. Saeed, I'll take a rank there and a Scepter ammo. Infernal Grenade. Garrus. Or Concussive Shot. For him, I'll take Heavy Concussive Shot, actually. Has explosives. Power cells, I guess, for the mech. Is there anything here? Like anything that can attack us? Data pad. I paid Harrod good money for this useless heap of signal error. Detected serious caches of resources here on this planet, but memory leak detected. Alright, I said sure, the thing leaks fuel like a volus after a mug of ring call, but I can deal with that. So I took off and laid out a trail of power cells leading from where I unloaded the mech to bad package, please restart, so I could at least get the thing moving. And now, illegal fault detected, won't even move. Damn that swindling Alcor. Piece of signal error. Restore memory. Okay. Do I want to be doing this? Well, I done did it. Feed fuel pound. Insert power cell. What do we have here in the journal? Can't save here. Mining the canyon. Feed fuel pods to the mech so we can find and excavate the resources inside the canyon walls. I guess they keep finding fuel pods. We have one.
That's all of them.
Yeah. I'm guessing we're gonna find more fuel stuff here. That's pretty cool, huh? Alive, these freaking things?
That one hit.
Wee. Oosh. Well, more power cells and this thing shut down. I just want to see what would happen. This is a saveless mission, huh? Can't say I approve, really.
Clear your visor, Shepard.
I didn't shoot you. That's neat. He knew I was wearing a visor. That was pretty cool. Go, baby. How does it even know where to go, though? Did it, like, feed the coordinates into it already before I left? I thought he was saying mech. I was like, what? Okay, it's going this way. Oh, here's more. they're gonna blast stuff apart? Okay. I'm gonna get out of the way then. Did I even do anything? Oh, crap. Oh! Was that supposed to happen? It blew itself up? Examine the resources. 5,000 platinum. Thank you. Is there more Varen coming or something? These things are tough, huh? Oh, it was easy. Okay. Recovered buried cache of resources, Emer tech unsalvageable. 125 experience, 7,500 credits, 5,000 platinum. That's a little mini mission. It took me at most 10 minutes, maybe less. Okay, that's this whole system. Balor 80%. Why is this 80%? I missed something.